La 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 la. Figaro, huh? Hey, Figaro. Figaro, huh? Hey, Figaro. Figaro, la 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 la.
Figaro, a Figaro, 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 Figaro.
Hey, Billy.
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. James, sir, yes, hello, hello.
Was that you?
Well, I was just testing the microphone. Hello, 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 test, 1, 2. Just testing the microphone, making sure I didn't know anybody was in here, and I didn't know anybody would hear me, so.
That was great, Billy, that was fun. You're a little Bugs Bunny, a little Figaro Figaro.
Well, I've just been warming up my voice.
You have quite a range. I didn't know you could get down to those low notes, and you know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Well, that's not it now, but you were doing it there. It's kind of like, you know, it's like people that can sing in the shower, but they can't sing anywhere else.
No, I don't know what you mean.
Nothing, never mind. Anyways, hey, it's the James Arnold Taylor podcast. James Arnold Taylor here, Billy there on the microphone. I just went in to get myself a little, you know what I have over here, Billy? Hey.
Oh, yes, Mr. James, you have a green apple there.
Yeah, I do. I have a green apple, and I want to talk about, you know, some of the things, like I always talk about water, which I have my water here as well, but things that I can use in a voiceover session when my voice is maybe not right there and, you know, all that. And so a green apple is something that you use quite a bit. And if you go into a recording studio where there's, you know, recording voices and such, you'll see they usually have green apples hanging out. And people would say, oh, that's nice, they have apples in it. No, no, they're there for a reason. And we'll talk about that today on the show. What do you think?
Oh, I think that's a wonderful, excellent idea, sir. I think that you always, as a voice actor, you're always giving information and all of that. And say, okay,
that's fine. I'm still impressed with your singing. Hey, Hank! Hank!
Yeah. Hello. Oh, you made me check. You're doing the podcasting?
Podcast.
Yeah, that's what I said. Podcasting.
No, but podcast. Why can't you ever just say things the way that they're supposed? Yeah, never mind. Anyways, Hank, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. You don't need to get that close. You set up the other microphone over there.
This one over here? You want me to talk on this one? Hello, 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 hello. That's another SC Electronics microphone there.
SC Electronics mic. You know, I'm going on about them because, well, they're now kind of like a, I don't know, I guess we could call them like a sponsor, you know, only in that I like their mics. They like that I like their mics. And so I talk about them. But yes, we have the SE Electronics. We have a couple of them here now in the booth set up. So you guys are not on my microphone, which happened last time in the episode. And I'm still holding this green apple. Let me put this green apple down. Hang on one second. So Billy was singing. Did you hear that, Hank?
What was he singing?
He was singing like Figaro, you know, like Figaro, Figaro.
Figaro, Figaros.
Don't do that, Hank.
What? I'm just singing it too. I got a pretty good voice. I can sing it.
Okay, that's not a good idea.
Oh no, Mr. Hankhurst, sir, I can give you some lessons.
You give me. The little kid that is a little intern.
Yeah, well, he's a young man, but he knows stuff, Hank. I mean, young people know a lot of stuff, Hank. Look at that. I've turned it into a the more you know. Oh, let's bring in George, the announcer guy. George.
Yeah, James. Great to see ya.
Thank you, George. You're always so happy.
Yes, I am. That's what I do.
Hey, George, can you say the whole more you know thing?
Sure, James. Cue that music, Jerry the Music Man.
You got it, George.
That sounded kind of funny. You got it, George. Anyways.
This has been a More You Know moment on the Chatcast.
Thanks, George, the announcer guy. That's Mr. Announcer Guy's brother, George, in case you're new to the show. We have a lot of different announcers in here. And a lot of people, and yeah, you guys are still, what, Hank?
Well, no, you were talking about the kids know a lot of stuff, and I was kind of laughing at Billy, because Billy was going to teach me how to sing, because like, I don't know how to sing. Let me sing you a song. Figaro!
Okay, you got it. You've got to stop that. Anyways, Billy, maybe you and Hank should go while I do the podcast, and you give him some vocal lessons somewhere outside of here.
Oh, yes, sir, Mr. James. That's an excellent idea, sir. Okay, Mr. Hank, come on with me, and I'll give you some figure. Do-re-mi.
Do-re-mi.
Ooh, no. Do-re-mi.
Do-re-mi.
Okay, guys, go work that out.
Do re mi fa sol la si.
Okay. They're going to work it out. Welcome to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. You know, it's funny. I was looking on, the JatCast, the podcast here, talking to myself, has a Twitter handle, and I was looking on that. I haven't been on Twitter much lately, and I was looking at the JatCast Twitter stuff and the feeds, and there's this this thing pops up because I follow a different podcasting places and people and things, and one of the questions was, what is the most annoying thing for you when listening to a podcast? And like the top one was people going off on tangents before actually getting to the show. Which is my whole show. I mean, so you either love it or you hate it, I guess. And if any of you are like, why doesn't he ever get on with the show? This is the show. That's the whole point. This show is just me. It's me talking to me. The show is called Talking to Myself. I do all the characters. I do them live. There's no edits in this. I've considered at times having cameras up and doing like a video version of the podcast. And I there is one that you can see. I did it one time, and you can see that on my YouTube channel. And check that out if you're new to it all. But you can see me actually doing the voice and see that I switch back and forth and do that, because people were questioning whether or not he edits it. And no, I don't. But I considered having cameras. But the only thing is to me, for all of you that listen to this show, you have in your mind what Hank looks like. You have in your mind what Billy looks like, or Mr. Announcer Guy, or any of the characters that I do on the show. You have in your mind even what I'm looking like doing the show, I'm sure. So for me, as somebody that has grown up from 4 years old, loving voice, always wanting to do voices and create story through voice and sound and music, this is the arena. This audio podcast is the arena for that. So putting up cameras, while it would be neat to see me doing it, and I will do it from time to time, maybe once every 6 months or something, I'll put a camera in and do an episode like that. Or I've thought about, if I ever actually did do any kind of like subscription stuff, that I'd film all the episodes, and for people that want to see it, they could watch me doing it in the studio here. So I don't do cameras in here. I do just audio because I want to create the illusions of all these characters coming in, talking to me while I talk to myself, because the show's called Talking to Myself. And on that note, Mr. Segway, let's bring in Mr. Announcer Guy to introduce the show. Hey, Mr. Announcer Guy!
Oh, yes, James.
How are you?
I'm doing good, man. I'm always doing good. You always go, how are you? And I go,
oh, that was a good impression of me. Was that you doing me?
Yeah, man, that was my Mr. Jat impression.
Do it again.
Hi, how are you?
Well, that's pretty good. Okay, so yeah, you come in, I say, hey, Mr. Announcer Guy, and then you say, yes, James, and I say, how are you? And then you say, I'm doing great, man, how are you? And I say, I'm doing pretty good, and then we go on with the show, and then that's where we're at right now, I guess.
Yeah, man.
Hey, so today on the show, we're going to talk about these green apples, because you, as an announcer guy, you would know that.
Oh, yeah, man, I love green apples. I eat them all the time. It helps my voice.
That's right. So we're going to talk about, we'll talk about some of those things, vocal health and stuff. So, you know, I don't know if that's going to be in your intro.
Let's find out, man. Cue that music, Jerry the Music Man.
You got it, Mr. Announcer Guy. Here you go.
Thanks, dude. Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, it's the James Arnold Taylor Podcast. Talking to myself, the JatCast. On today's show, Jat's going to talk about vocal health, green apples, and get lost on tangents.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. And now, here he is, the same guy that's doing all the voices you hear, including this one, James Arnold Taylor!
Hey, thanks, dude.
You got it, dude.
Hey, how are you liking this new SE Electronics 2200 mic?
I think it's cool, dude. It's the official mic of the James Arnold Taylor Podcast.
That's right. Thanks to all the folks at SE Electronics. Go to SEElectronics.com and check out their vast array of microphones and gear. They've got some cool gear, man. They've got this thing, Dynamite, this cool little deal that helps with mics that are like ribbon mics and stuff and give you more dB. All the technical stuff I will pass right over, but they can explain it all to you much better. Check out SEElectronics.com. If you're just into gear and stuff, great stuff. I love it all. All right, Mr. Announcer Guy, are you going to go now?
Yeah, but you took my line.
Oh, sorry. Okay, pretend I didn't say it.
All right, man. Well, you got to say your thanks,
Oh, yeah, okay, oh, yeah. Thanks, Mr. Announcer Guy.
You got it, man. I'm going to go now.
And there he goes. And there's the music. And look at that, we're only probably, I don't know, 11 minutes into the show before getting to the intro of the show. I just got a kick out of that on the podcast things of saying like, yeah, before getting to the thing, they just talk too much. I think on that, that's probably on shows where people are interviewing other people and say, oh, we got a great show today. We're going to do this and this and this. And then they get off on tangents and they don't get to it. On this show, I did kind of do that saying we're going to talk about green apples and stuff. But this show is just me hanging out in my studio talking to you and telling whatever kind of comes to mind. I don't plan this show. I don't have any like, I was cutting a green apple downstairs to have this morning. It's about 11:50 a.m. Well, it's not about, it is 11:50 a.m. on a Friday. It is, what day is it? It's Friday, December 10th, as I record this. And it's the morning. And, well, not the morning. It's pre-noon now. And I was cutting up a green apple to have as a little snack and to get my voice ready. I'd done my vocal exercises and all of that. And I thought, you know what? I should do a podcast here because I've got some stuff happening. I'm waiting today for a delivery. Now, have you ever... of course, I don't have to even ask that question. All of us have waited for deliveries, especially in this day and age now. Everything is just waiting and waiting. So we ordered a mirror. We're doing a room that is a workout room, like a little gym, like a mini. It's just one of the bedrooms, and we're converting it into a space to do workout stuff. We have a little exercise bike in there, and we've got weights and stuff in there. And what we're putting in is a big mirror. It's like 4 foot by, I don't know, 7 foot tall, and they're going to deliver it today. I'll mount it up on the wall this weekend, and then we're going to put a ballet bar up because my daughter does ballet and she's done ballet forever, and so all of us can work out there in different ways and have, you know, all that. So it's fun. So I'm waiting for the people at Home Depot to deliver, and that's not an advertisement for Home Depot, but that's where I got it. I got it from Home Depot. People ask, where do you get your stuff? That's where I get it. So I went to Home Depot, I got online, and I ordered this big mirror because they were the only ones that really had exactly what I was looking for. And I got this mirror, and they're going to deliver it, and then they're going to bring it up because it's upstairs, and it's a big mirror, so they're going to bring that up. So I'm waiting. So at any point in time, while I'm doing this podcast, I could get a text from my wife saying, hey, they're coming over. And then I'd have to stop. But you won't know. You know why? The magic of editing. Now, even though I say on this show I don't do any edits when I'm doing the voices, but I will sometimes take a break, you know, go in, do an audition, do something else. If the phone rings, I got to take a call. I'll hit stop and then I'll pick it back up. But I cut that stuff out because, you know, I generally, now there's different ways you can podcast. And a lot of people will just kind of hit record and go. And that's what you get. I like to go through. I like to fine tune it. I like to do the post-production after the fact. So I just come in here, the way I do a podcast, I come in, I hit record, I've got a touch screen, a big Raven MTI Slate touch screen in the booth that I can control things from there. So I can control my Pro Tools and stuff here. And I hit record when I get in the booth, and I just record the vocals. And that is primarily how I've done most of my work throughout my 36 years in radio and production. I record the voice first, then I go back and do post-production. I add the music and sound effects and all of that stuff. So, hey, are you drinking water? You know the rule on the James Arnold Taylor podcast, water. That's good water. Are you drinking? And sorry for those of you that have that, there's an actual thing where you don't like to hear people chew and eat and stuff. Lip smacks. And some people have that. And I have it to a degree at times. So I always try to not go too far with the smacking and everything. But sometimes when you're, as a voice actor, when you're doing cartoons, you have to do that. And I always wonder how the engineers are, if they're one of those people that has that thing. And they're like, oh gosh, I can't stand listening to this person chew. Anyways, okay. That is a tangent and I was off on it. Anyways, I record the show that way. I record my voice. Then I go through, tighten things up, take out little andas and all that stuff. And I add the music and the sound effects. But basically, when I'm switching back and forth in the voices, that's all real time. I don't make any edits there. Because I never know what the characters are going to say, because I'm a nut. I hope everybody enjoyed the last podcast. I was so thrilled to see all the nice comments and stuff there. You know, I know I've said I've taken comments off of YouTube, but the new videos that I'm putting up for the podcast, for example, I've been leaving comments up to allow all of you there to kind of say stuff. So enjoy. But all my past videos and stuff, I did take comments off of just because I was tired of people trying to go through there and try to find ways to either insult or accuse, you know, and that's day and age. That's too much, isn't it? I think it's too much. Anyways, so comments are turned off on a lot of my videos on YouTube, but not on all of them. And this one, you certainly can leave comments as you did on the last one. Hey, should we take a look at some of those? Because that's all we're doing here. We're just kind of, you know, we're just hanging out together. And that's what I think what most of you like about the JatCast. Let's take a look. I'm pulling up here the YouTubes on a little iPad. So I got all sorts of different gear here in the studio. I keep an iPad here to read my scripts. And that's how I read my scripts. Hang on, go to home. Wait, where's me? Where am I? My videos. There it is, talking to myself, the podcast. Oh, you're going to hear me talk? Whoops, there I am talking. Okay, so let's go to comments. Where are the comments? Oh, there are the comments. Okay, let me take a look. Let's read through some of your comments that you've left. Kaylee Mead, I hope I'm pronouncing your right name right. Your name right, Kaylee. Hey, Bob. Hey, let's get Bob in here to help me out with this. Hey, Bob. Hey, Bob.
Oh, yes, indubitably, indubitably, James. Oh, yes. Wonderful to see you there. And look at that. You have a little iPad with comments and things. Would you like me to read these?
Yes, Bob, I think that would be great. Since we're not doing emails currently, there is no way to email me. Many of you have asked, can I email you? I don't currently have that. If you've listened to past episodes of the podcast, when we did have the link for emails, you could do that. But now I don't have emails up and running right now. As I explained in the last episode, I'll explain it again briefly here. It's just, I've been overwhelmed by all of them and I've been overwhelmed by all your kindness. And so there are so many emails that it's been hard to keep up. So we have turned off the emails for now, but not to fear, you can still make comments here on the videos on YouTube. You can make comments or ratings. Oh boy, do I appreciate it when you give me a 5-star rating on the iTunes and give me a review. We'll read some of those as well, Bob.
Oh yeah, indubitably. I was looking and there's some good ones there. They're very nice, very kind people.
Thank you, Bob. Yes, they are kind people. I love you all. I pray for you all the time. I do. Okay, so this one, right?
Oh, yeah, and Kaylee.
That's what I said. Yeah, Kaylee before.
Oh, that's how I'm pronouncing it, too. So I hope that's right, Kaylee. Okay, so happy you're back. It's great to listen to you because you're such a nice and positive person. Bless you and your family and then a little heart.
Oh, a little heart. That's nice. Well, thank you, Kaylee. That is so nice of you. That was 2 hours ago. Look at that. I'm so appreciative of all of your folks' comments. What's this one?
Oh, that's Comborico. Comborico.
I think that's how you're saying it. I think you're saying it right.
That may be a zero and then R-I-C-O.
I think that is a zero in the middle, Bob.
It says, glad you're feeling better.
Oh, well, thank you. Yes, no, I am feeling better. Talked a little bit about that before on the last episode. You can listen to episode 52 and hear about that. Derek Frank, look at that. The Derek Frank. The Derek Frank is a good friend of mine and here. And so glad to see him there. What did Derek put on there?
Oh, yes, it was his, the Derek Frank. He says, so great to have you back and feeling better. I can hear God's joy in your voice shining through that beautiful new microphone.
Well, yeah, see, now I'm laughing too. So the Derek Frank, if you do a YouTube stuff, if you go to, who doesn't? Go to YouTube, check out the TheDerekFrank. The Derek Frank. Amazing musician and great guy. Who has his own stuff on his channel, and he is a tech dude, and he knows the tech, and he knows the people, and he knows the people that make the tech, and he's the one that introduced me to the fine folks at SE Electronics, and so I'm very grateful to the Derek Frank for doing that. So please, give him a follow, give him a subscribe on his channel. He's building up more stuff there. Here's the cool thing. Derek's got it all figured out, man. You go to his YouTube channel, and you're looking at him. His studio's amazing. He's got a beautiful studio. And you go, ooh, what's that? I want to know what that screen is behind him or that microphone or that camera that he's using or the lighting. He's got it all listed on his, and I guess I should do this stuff. I'm such an old man. I don't do any of these things right to where you can monetize this stuff and make it work for you better and all. Maybe someday I'll hire someone to do that for me. I don't know, but then all the money that I make would just go right to that person. But anyway. But Derek's got it all figured out. So he lists all of the gear you see in his videos. So if you're curious, and then you can click on it, and then it'll take you to a link to how to buy that. And if you buy it, then, you know, he might make a little something from that, which is great. And then you get that equipment because he's got some cool gear. He's a nerd for tech just like I am. So anyways, check out Derek Frank, okay? The Derek Frank. And follow him on social media as well. I believe it is at The Derek Frank as well on like Instagram and Twitter and all that stuff. So give him a follow and tell him that James Arnold Taylor sent you. Oh, we should get some type of an... That's Mr. Announcer Guy's like cousin or something. We brought him in once before. Hey, Mr. Announcer Guy!
Yes, James?
If we have like the kind of the Phil Hartman-y kind of, you know, goody-goody kind of announcer guy, that's your cousin?
Yeah, man, I guess so.
Okay, yeah, well, I'm making it up as I go. Can we get him in here?
Hello, James. How are you?
I'm good. I don't even remember what I was going to have you announce. I'd have to go back and listen to what I was saying. But can you do some kind of like a little...
Check out The Derek Frank for more.
Yeah, something like that. That was good. Well, you kind of did it there. So there you go. Thanks there, nice Mr. Super Nice Announcer Guy.
You're welcome, James. We'll see you later.
Okay. That was nice. That was just new. I was just making that up. Bob.
Yes, but oh, yes, yeah.
What else we got?
Oh, this is from Debbie Prentice. Says, so happy to have you back. I've missed you so much. Sorry to hear about your vertigo, and I hope you're feeling a lot better. I had vertigo in the past, but my dad, who's been through it, gave me a lot of advice and found some great exercises. The best thing is to not feel scared. Try to be as calm as possible, and you'll be fine.
That's so true, Debbie. Thank you.
When she says, you're absolutely right to take a break from social media, it can overwhelm the senses and most of it's toxic. So it's important to detoxify once in a while. I do want to send you an email, but I'll wait till you're comfortable with accepting them again. It's so nice to hear Billy, the sweet intern and Mr. Announcer Guy again, but I hope to hear George, that romantic guy. I can't resist a bit of romance. And then there's little hearts and flowers and little smiley faces.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Well, thank you, Debbie. Yeah, George was just on the show, wasn't he? But so, hey, George, the announcer guy, Mr. Announcer Guy's brother, George.
Yeah, James.
Well, you're fast. Can you do a little message for Debbie Prentice?
Sure, James. Give me some music, Jerry the Music Man.
You got it, George the Romantic Announcer Guy.
Dear Debbie, hope you're having a super fantastic day listening to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. And today... may there be a little romance in your life.
Thanks, George. That was nice. That was nice for you to do for Debbie.
You got it, James. I'm gonna go now.
Well, he says it differently, doesn't he? Okay, well, see ya, George. There you go, Debbie. Thank you. So what else we got?
Oh, yes, we got one. Oh, from Elliot Allman.
Elliot. Love Elliot. He's a great kid. Young man. I'm sorry, Elliot. You're not a kid. You're a young man. I say everybody's a kid, Elliot. You gotta understand. That's what I do. I call my wife a kid. And she's younger than me. Anybody younger than me, I call a kid. So there you go.
Oh, yes, you're right. Elliot says, it's good to hear your podcast again, James. Thank you for sharing your life with us and have a great holiday season.
Thank you, Elliot. I hope you and your family do as well. Many blessings and hope and peace and grace and all of that to you and your family. Please give your family my best, Elliot. All right? God bless you, my friend.
Okay, and MC Voices says, and just when the world needed him, he returned! Exclamation point. Welcome back, Jat.
Well, thank you, MC Voices. Yo, yo, MC Voices with the MC and the voices. I don't know. Anyways, I'm just making stuff up.
Here's one from Azurus Star. Says, glad to see you're back. Love from France.
Well, that's nice.
Ho, ho. Hello. Bonjour.
Well, no, what do I say? What do I say for hello?
Hello.
But thank you, Azura Star. I was doing a French accent on a cartoon recently. Just a subtle French accent when I do that. But I think that a lot of people, they will do ha ha, and that, you know, that maybe, I hope that's not offensive to anybody in France, but I have a good friend of mine that's an engineer, Laurent, and he is funny, and he gives me a bad time, and I give him a bad time. So he says, how are you, James? And I say, I am doing good, Laurent, how are you? And he says, I'm doing good, my friend. And then we talk to each other with a French accent. But his French accent is real, and mine is fake. Anyways, okay. And, whoop, I just got a text from my wife. Delivery should arrive in about a half hour. He has a couple others before us, but still said half hour. Okay, so in a half hour, I'll probably be wrapping up on the podcast here. But then my delivery will come. Look at that. My day is just going places, right? I've got, oh, let me reply to my wife so she knows that I got that. I'm going to reply with a little heart. Oh, isn't that nice? Aren't I sweet? Okay, my day's going good. I doing a podcast, going to get a delivery. Then my friend Matthew Buds, who I'm working with, I talk to you all about this movie. I want to talk about that. But so, Bob, I'm sorry. I'm off on a tangent. Bob, let's wrap these up here, yeah?
Oh, yeah. So, well, James, there's so many different comments here. And people, if they want to ask you a question or comment or say hello or anything right now, the best way to do it is either on the comments section in the YouTubes of the podcast that come out when they come out.
That's right, Bob.
Or you can follow James on social media at Instagram, at Jat Actor, at J-A-T Actor. And then whenever he posts, you can go ahead and ask him a question there.
That's right.
Oh, and then they can also go at Jat Actor on Twitter.
Yeah, Twitter as well. We can do that if we want. But anyways, so those are great ways. Bob, thank you so much for reading some of those. We'll read some more of this stuff later, but I want to get on to some other parts of the show. And I just can't thank you all enough for all that you do in thanking me. Yeah, it's a big thank you fest.
Oh, yeah, oh, indubitably, indubitably. Thank you, James.
All right, Bob, we'll see you in a bit.
Okay, oh, yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And there he goes. Thank you all. Yeah, we'll read more of those. We only read a couple, I'm sorry, but we will try to read off some names and thank you. And thank you all of you for doing that. You know, I was talking about, what was I talking about? What the heck was I talking? This is the problem when you're as ADD as me. People go, why would I want to listen to a show of a guy just randomly spazzing out like that? I don't know, but this is, you know, the show is called Talking to Myself, to be fair, and I do kind of just ramble on, so I guess you get what you pay for, which is free. All right. Oh, yes, I was talking about my buddy Matthew Buds, who was thrilled that I mentioned his name in the podcast last time. So hang on. So I have a green apple here. Hang on. I won't eat it on the mic because I don't want to be rude, but for any of you that are sensitive to the sound of eating. Anyways, the green apple. Why do I eat the green apple? So the green apple is good. That's a good apple. Anyways, I'll explain later about the green apple. But so my buddy Matthew Buds and myself have been writing a script for a new movie that we want to shoot. And we're making headway to shoot it. I finished the script. So the way we've been doing this, for any of you that are looking for creative endeavors and how to help each other. So I've had this idea kicking around in my head for a long time. And Matt and I were talking about different ways that we could work together and do stuff together. He's a producer of things and I produce things and we both write. So I told him about this idea. And every time we get together, we start talking about it and kept coming back to it. Like we talk about different movie ideas and shows and stuff that we could write and come up with because we want to develop content that is family friendly, good stuff for anybody to watch, not necessarily pushing any, Christian message in it, but to have the people in it happen to be Christian because that happens to be life or not. And there you go. And so we want to just make stuff that is, again, stuff that anybody could watch. That's always been the rule for me. People will be like, well, why don't you do these video games and all this stuff? I can say, well, or TV shows that are adult. Well, I want to do stuff that I would be comfortable watching with my daughter. My daughter's 16 now, and so she's pretty aware of a lot of things going on in the world. She's not just in a, you know, isolation on it. But still, there's things that are appropriate and things that aren't appropriate. There's things that you should be watching and things you shouldn't be watching. There's a ton of stuff now I find on television that will say it's, you know, TV PG, but it'll still have stuff in it that is like completely inappropriate, in my opinion. We want to make stuff that is just straight up like how you would be in your normal day. Like in my normal day, I don't go cursing and all that. And a lot of people do, I guess. So that's why movies now that come out have all that stuff in it, which is upsetting to me, but I'd rather there be positive. So many movies now are pretty depressing too. That's the main thing for me. When I go on like any of my streaming services and I look and I say, oh, new movies. And it's always just really depressing stuff. There's a time and a place for dramas and movies like that that stir you in that way and evoke emotions out of you in certain ways. But I think for the most part, most of us want to be inspired. I think that's why so many of you listen to this podcast, for example. You'll sit there and take an hour of your day to listen to some guy ramble in a booth doing wacky voices to himself, talking about tangents and stuff there where he goes off on them, rather. Because at the end of the day, hopefully at the end of this podcast, you feel better and you feel a little uplifted and you feel like you spent time with a friend. Now, if I go and hang out with friends, I want my friends to be happy. You know, and that's biblical to me too. You want to hang out with like-minded people, but people that bring you up, don't bring you down, right? So when I make stuff, I want to make sure it brings you up. It lifts you up. When I was a kid and I watched movies, the things that made impacts on me were movies that ended with happy endings, were movies that ended on an upbeat tone that gave you positivity, that made you feel hope. But I am telling you, man, Hollywood, wake up, okay? Most people do not want to watch a depressing,
based on a true story.
Oh, I went into Jake, the announcer guy, there for a second. That is nothing but death, destruction, sadness, depression, anxiety. I mean, we all have enough of that. Hollywood, get back to it. Do yourself a favor, Hollywood. Go watch An American in Paris, Singing in the Rain, It's a Wonderful Life. Classic movies that bring excitement and joy and fun. Look at movies even from the 80s, you know, even if they are, some of these are maybe a little more crude and stuff, you know, like Steve Martin movies like The Jerk or The Man with Two Brains or Dead Men Don't Wear Plaid or Summer School, which was a Carl Reiner film, or, you know, there's plenty of movies from my younger years. Obviously, the John Hughes movies. A lot of these, though, do have a lot of language and sex and stuff in them. So that's why I'm kind of saying cautiously. But at the same time, at the end of the day, those movies, you laughed. You felt good. You didn't feel like you need to bathe and, like, wash the slime off of you. And I rarely find a movie now. Rarely, even ones that are PG and PG-13 that don't have some agenda pushed in them or whatever. So I just remember being inspired by movies, and I want to inspire people. So that's what Matt and I are trying to do, is make stuff like that. I've written a script with the help of Matt. So I do the writing. Matt and I get together and we talk through all of the scenes. Now he's got a script that he wants to do, and then he'll do the writing on that. And then he and I will meet and talk about the scenes on that. But so that was the creative process for us. As he comes over, he's going to come over later, and we're going to talk through some stuff too, where we just work on things that are important to us, but things that we think will also help all of you at the end of your day feel better when you turn on that streaming service and go, what's on tonight? Oh, I can watch this one. I can watch The Comic Shop. That's the name of the movie. That's as much as I'm going to give you. Well, maybe should I give you all more? Should I give you... Okay, exclusive to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. Ooh, well, I need somebody to come in and say it's a James Arnold Taylor exclusive. Hey, Mr. Announcer Guy!
Yeah, man, I'm on it. Now, it's a James Arnold Taylor podcast exclusive. Copyright 2021.
Thanks, dude.
You got it, dude.
So, I can give you all here a little bit of information about the movie that I just wrote. You want that? You guys want to hear about it? I'll pretend you all said yes. So I've had this idea for a very long time. I'm not going to get into all the specifics of it. It is all copywritten though too. So I don't need to, I guess, worry about anybody ripping me off at this point. Although, well, you always need to worry about people ripping you off because it will happen. But this is the film that we just finished writing, conceptualizing, is called The Comic Shop. And it is about a comic book shop and a collectible, a vintage collectible and comic book shop. And they have, I'll say this. It is, I don't want to give the whole thing away here. Picture The Breakfast Club at a comic book shop. There you go. All right. Five kids waiting for something. I'm not even going to get into what they're waiting for. Although they're waiting for someone to appear. I'll give you that. At this comic book shop in a small town. And we get to learn about their lives as they sit waiting and why what they're waiting for is so important to them. Okay? There you go. That's the film. It's written. We're going to start producing it soon. We're going to start casting it soon. And I'm excited about that. So anyways, so that's what I'm working on now. I had previously written a film that was different. So the other one is on the shelf right now. We'll make it at some point. I will make that movie someday. But this one, I will be in. Catherine Tabor will be in. My friend Matthew Buds will be in. And some up-and-coming, very talented young people who we have not yet cast or even found yet. So maybe you're one of them. Maybe you're one of them. There you go. You never know. And here's the other thing I'm going to say. It takes place in a comic book shop. So we're going to be looking for comic book art and artists and animators. So I know I've opened a floodgate now by even saying all of this to all of you. But if you're an artist and you're a good artist that does stuff, we may be creating a little thing that says, hey, if you'd like to have your stuff featured in the movie, in the background, just in the background, and that would be you wouldn't get paid for this or anything. It would just be, your art would be sitting in the background on a shelf or something. There's possibilities. We're talking about that. So anyways, wow, man, I gave you so much. I did not plan on talking about this at all, but see what happens? I sit here, I get comfortable with all of you, and I care for all of you, and I believe in all of you, and I believe that what I do and what inspires me can help inspire you, because I believe inspiration is contagious. I believe God's love is contagious. I do. I believe that His Holy Spirit can work through people to touch other people, even if they don't believe in Him, to be inspired and to do things that they never thought they could do, and then do them, and then maybe, just maybe, they might find that touch from God, because that's always my overarching theme in my life, is I want to show people the joy of the Lord, because the joy of the Lord is in my heart, because I have it in my heart. And I want to show all of you what that looks like. So there you go. So shared with you is a little bit of information about the comic shop. And I think it's going to be fun. We're going to have a good time shooting it. We're going to get together my group of friends that help: James Burns, Jesse Chapman, Alexander Stevens, Matthew Buds, all these guys who I hope are listening, and I hope they're thrilled to hear their names. These are very talented young filmmakers. See, I, as the old guy, I'm an old man. I know, I'm really not that old. But you got to understand, I have always been the young guy. I was always that young kid that did, because I started when I was 16 in all of this. And so I've always been that kind of the kid that came in and figured it out and did all that. And now I'm still the same size. I haven't grown up. Everybody else got taller. I didn't get any taller. And I still have this little voice.
Oh, I can do this voice too, man.
Hey, I sound like Mr. Announcer Guy. But I feel, it's funny because I'm 52 now. So I'm like, wow, I'm the guy that's mentoring young people. And that's wonderful. So it's a wonderful young group of filmmakers, and I'm thrilled to attach myself to all of them and teach what I can and give what I can, because I also know that they could do amazing things if given the right opportunities. So hopefully we all have the right opportunities. And if any of you are sitting there on a big stack of cash going, man, I'm sitting on all this money. I don't know what to do with it. I wish I could invest it in a movie. Hey, let me know. Give me a call. So we'll be looking for investors and stuff for this thing too. And we're going to start that whole thing. You know, people have asked me, oh, will you do crowdfunding? I don't know. You know, I'm not a big crowdfunding guy, just because I've always felt funny about taking money from people that like what I do. That's why I have trouble with signing autographs and stuff. I'm not doing any signings really anymore. I will be at a Comic-Con. I have one Comic-Con that I do, and that is in Nashville, Tennessee. And I will be going to that con end of April, beginning of May. And that is my friend Michael Havens, who does that con. It is ICCC. And it is, you can look them up and find that, Nashville Comic Con, ICCC. And Michael and his lovely wife, Andrea, do this out of the goodness of their heart, their love of Comic Cons, their love of Star Wars and pop culture, Marvel and DC and everything else. They have a wonderful store. I've put that in my Instagram before, where we visited their store. We were there yesterday, actually, as well. And we are going to be shooting at their store, as well as probably another store in Tennessee called Z's Comic Lair. And I like to say it's a comic lair. But we're going to combine both of those places to where we'll shoot this film, which we're very excited about. But anyway, so I will be at Michael's con in April, end of April, beginning of May, and Ian McDiarmid will be there. And I am trying, also another JAT exclusive.
It's another JATcast exclusive.
Wow, you came in quick. Thanks, dude.
You got it, man.
I'm trying to get my Clone Wars castmates to show up with me at this Comic-Con at the end of April and beginning of May, and see if we could do a little Clone Wars reunion, because I am not going to be any other cons. So people keep asking, oh, will you go to this con? Will you go? No, I'm not doing any more Comic Cons, and I'm not really signing stuff anywhere anymore. And so, you know, I may do other ones at some point. I'm not saying, no, I'll never do it. Just right now, I'm taking a break from all of them except that one, okay? That one is just, it's easy for me to do, and I love all the people involved. I love all the folks there that come out to Nashville for it. So that's what I'm doing. Anyways, this episode has kind of gone places I didn't expect it to go. I should talk about the green apple and why I have that. A green apple, why is it effective for voiceover? Well, okay. So when you're doing a voice and you that kind of clicky sound, so when you're talking and you get those little in your mouth and you're doing, you're like, how do I get rid of that? Get a green apple, take a bite. And what a green apple does, sorry for everybody if you don't want to hear somebody eating, I apologize. This green apple helps you activate your saliva glands and helps take away that little click sound that happens in your mouth. So you always, when you're doing voiceover, want to have some sliced green apple on hand because it helps in case they're listening and they go, James, you got a little click in your mouth, a little clicky sound, and you're sounding a little dry, a little, you know, you get that, sorry, it's kind of gross, but a little pasty sound or something. Green apple will help. So that's a little voiceover 101 for you. That was another voice guy come in and say,
it's time for a voiceover 101 lesson with James Arnold Taylor.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Friendly Announcer Guy's Cousin Guy.
You got it, James.
All right. I'm sure you've been on the show before and I gave you another name, but I can't remember right now. Okay. That's a little voiceover 101 tip there, a little tip and trick. It only took 50 minutes for me to get to it. And it was really only like 60 seconds of talking. And the rest of the show is just about all this other cool stuff that I'm doing. So working on this movie with Matthew Budge, and we are actually, I don't know if any of you are in the Tennessee area and go to Lipscomb University, but we're going to be checking out Lipscomb University and doing some casting probably of the film through Lipscomb. So I'm excited about this project. Talking about it helps make it real. And so that's probably why I'm feeling the need to talk about it. You know, I always pray about these things. I don't want to give out information that I shouldn't. It's like I said on the last one, I gave very personal stories and I pray about them. And you know, my friend Matthew, who was kind enough to listen to it, which is really funny. You know, I always feel it's weird. It's like, I don't ever want to ask my friends, hey man, do you listen to my podcast? But they do. And I think that that's very nice. My family listens to it. It's very nice. So I'm always grateful. So grateful, grateful. And he said, you know, what's great about your vulnerability in this is I think it helps other people. And that's my hope. Look, I'm a voice actor. I do voices in cartoons and video games and movies and all of that stuff. I don't talk about my life there because I'm not hired to do that. I'm hired to act and perform. So my podcast is the one place where I actually can just kind of talk to you and you can see who I am as a person. And you can choose to like that or not. And if you don't like that, that's cool, man. I get it. I may not be your speed. You know, I don't love every actor as well. I get it. You know, or I wouldn't want to spend the day with them or an hour with them. But some people would want to hang out with me for an hour and have lunch with me. And so this podcast is kind of my way of showing what it would be like. Now, granted, you don't get to talk in it. So that's a bummer. It's only me just going on and on and on. But it would be kind of weird if I just went, so tell me about you. And then I just said nothing for like 2 minutes on the show. That would be awkward. And I wouldn't know what you're saying. So there you go. So it's a one-sided conversation here, talking to myself, the podcast. But it does allow you to be, as I say, a fly on the wall in my life and hear the way I live, the way I believe, the way I think, what I'm working on that I can talk about. Because that's the other thing. I can talk about this movie because I'm doing it. It's not something that I'm doing with someone else. So, and I want to try to create a buzz about it because I would love that if people got excited about this movie and then we could get some distribution and get it made and get it out there. It's going to feature other voice actors. It's going to be about voice acting. It's going to be wonderful stories of voice actors in it as well. And I will be playing a voice actor. Look at that. I'm giving away more stuff. I won't be playing me. I will be playing a voice actor, a fictional character. And there will be fictional comic books and fictional movies and TV shows within this. So we're not talking about properties that we don't have the rights to talk about, right? So I can't do a movie like this where it's James Arnold Taylor talking about Star Wars and stuff because I'm not, you know, I don't own that. So we've created our own little world in this and we are going to, I think, have a lot of fun and inspire people through this film and also just give them something fun to watch. Look, this movie isn't going to change the world. This movie is just going to be something fun to watch and put on and hopefully be one of those things that you watch over and over and over again. You laugh at the jokes, you cry in the sad parts, and you feel good at the end of the movie. That's what movies are about. Okay, Hollywood, if you're listening, which you're not listening, you don't care about me. That's what movies are about, man. They don't need to put on some agenda. Some movies are made for that, to bring awareness. I am all for movies to bring awareness because those generally have an upbeat message at the end. They leave on a positive note. You feel inspired because you saw what happened, and then there's redemption at the end of the movie. That's great. But these movies that are just depressing movies, and, you know, and so many of them are based on a true story, yet they're just sad, you know? My wife and I tried watching this movie last night on Hulu with Annette Bening and Bill Nighy. And I love Bill Nighy. I love him in Love Actually and all these stuff. You know, he's he was in the Pirates of the Caribbean movies. I actually voice doubled for him on some stuff for that. And he's got such a great, you know, just love his way, man. You know, he's just a British accent and he's just so funny. But this movie, I'm like, oh, there's two great actors. And then their son was the gentleman, I forgive me, I don't remember his name. He's on The Crown and he played Prince Charles in the last season of The Crown and he was so good. And it's about this family. We watched this last night. We got halfway through it. And they're going through a divorce. And they're like, they've been married almost 30 years and they're going through. It was so depressing. It was so depressing. I'm like, I love all these actors, but man, this is depressing. And then my wife and I both started falling asleep. You have to understand, I never fall asleep in a movie. So for me to like doze off in a movie, it's got to be boring. So sorry, I can't remember the name of it even. So, and no offense to it, but boy, can we make some movies where you sit up and you watch them and you enjoy it? That's what I'm trying to do. So I wish Hollywood would do that more. I hope that they do. I hope that they use this time to see that we all are already sitting at home. Like the TV shows that have been like real life ones now that I might have watched in the past, like, you know, This Is Us or any of these ones that are A Million Little Things, all these shows that are, you know, kind of these evening soap dramas almost. And they all started telling stories about and made it about like COVID and all the stuff that's happened. I don't want to watch that. I just have lived that for almost 2 years. I don't need to turn on a TV and watch fake people having a fake time with this stuff. You, me, and everybody else has lived that. So I think it's funny how TV shows are doing that right now. It's like, well, but it's showing how we all handle it. Okay, maybe one or two, and there's an episode or something, but man, when I watch television and I watch movies, I want to escape. I want to be inspired. I want to be happy. So if I can do that, then my job is done. Ooh, I'm watching the camera. I wonder if is that my delivery? Might be my delivery. My camera froze right then. Nope, I think not. Okay, so that's what I'm working on. And I am going to try, because I think there's so many wonderful, talented people out there. Many of you that listen to this are wonderful, talented people in the arts. And you're all wonderful, talented people, but in the arts specifically. And we may be calling out to you to help us out with this movie. You never know. So be listening to more of the James Arnold Taylor podcast for more information about The Comic Shop and how we go further with it. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, and we'll shoot a lot of behind the scenes and we'll do all that stuff. And I think it'll just be a great time. Okay, so I thank you so much for taking the time to listen to the James Arnold Taylor podcast. Please go back and listen to the other ones if you haven't at all before. Please also share all of this stuff with other people. Please give me a 5-star rating on iTunes, or I don't know if Spotify does ratings or anything, but if so, wherever you're listening, give me a thumbs up or a good rating or a yeah, yeah, or a comment or a review. Write a review. Wonderful reviews. We didn't get to those this time. We will get to them next time. I'll read some of the reviews on the iTunes reviews, because those are fun and they make my heart sing and make me happy to see all of you enjoying what I do. I'm doing my best to do more episodes of this thing and keep it going on a regular basis for you. So please, please continue to follow me and subscribe and all that stuff. More videos coming out as well on my YouTube channel soon, I'm sure, and my Rumble channel. I do have both. I need to put them on both. And I'm not political about any of that junk, so anybody that's trying to get political about me having a Rumble account or a YouTube account or any of that, it's, look, I'm just somebody in the social world, and I put stuff out, and I have channels at different places. So there you go. I don't get into any of the political junk that goes on with all of this stuff, okay? I look at it as places for me to put my content. And if that offends somebody, here's the wonderful thing. You don't have to watch or listen to it, okay? You can just move on. So there you go. I pray the best for all of you to know what you believe, why you believe it, and to know more than you want to know today, and to do your best to be a good person and to help others and to love others, even those that don't love you. So important to do, really is. Because you breathe. have we been breathing throughout this? Have we been sipping our water and breathing and listening to the James Arnold Taylor podcast? I didn't really remind you, so I hope you were. If not, you know what you got to do? You got to go back and listen to it again and do it. Okay. Anyways, let's bring in Mr. Announcer Guy to close out the show. Hey, Mr. Announcer Guy!
Yeah, man, I'm getting my exercise.
Yeah, can you close out the show with the legal mumbo jumbo?
It's what I live for, man.
Do it!
Talking to Myself, the James Arnold Taylor Podcast is a production of Yumigo Inc., recorded at Chat Studios. Engineered, written, recorded, and produced by, you guessed it, James Arnold Taylor. All voices are parody and should be construed as entertainment only. All music and sound effects used with permissions and licenses through Backtracks, Digital Juice, Production Tracks, and Partners in Rhyme. James Arnold Taylor's Talking to Myself, the Podcast. Copyright 2021. All rights reserved.
Well, thank you, sir.
You got it, man. I hope you have a great week.
And I hope you have a great week as well, Mr. Announcer Guy, as well as all of you. We didn't do an Obi-Wan hello there or anything in here, did we? Hey, Obi-Wan.
Hello there.
Oh, there it is. Love the Obi-Wan Kenobi. Love the Star Wars, Clone Wars. Hey, please, please, if you don't know about Clone Wars, check it out. There are 7 seasons waiting for you to watch and enjoy. What a great show. What a great group of people. We need to talk about that maybe sometime here on the podcast. Or maybe, just maybe, we need a separate podcast for Star Wars and Clone Wars. Would you all like that? Let me know. Let me know in the comments if you'd like a separate podcast that deals with just Clone Wars stuff. I think that could be pretty great. I think it could. Okay. All right, everybody. God bless you, my friends. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so you may abound in hope by the power of his Holy Spirit. Okay? Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. It will be health to your body and strength to your bones. That's what I say. I didn't open with scripture, so I'll close with scripture this time there. Thank you all so much. God bless you. And we'll see you or hear you or listen. No, you'll hear me next time on the James Arnold Taylor Podcast. Bye-bye.